Now that you guys know a lot about bacteria and viruses, I thought maybe we could talk a little bit about fungus and mold, 'cause these guys are quite nasty, but also quite beautiful looking, depending on, well, which way you wanna think about them. So I thought I'm gonna tell you a little experiment to do with mold. Now, guys, have you ever, maybe forgotten your sandwich? Maybe for about, like, 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks in your backpack, and then opened your bag and then found this really disgusting looking thing. It's a thing because you can't really see the sandwich anymore as much, but there's a lot of different colors, and there's kind of like this cottony things inside, and it kind of smells really bad. Have you done this? Okay, well, now we're gonna try to do something similar, but you're in a more controlled environment, okay? Are you ready? I'm gonna show it to you in 3, 2, 1. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. You will take a slice of bread and you're going to split it in 4 pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, we're gonna have a little Ziploc bag for each one of them because we don't want this thing coming out of there, okay? And we wanna have it in a controlled environment. So, the first one will be just bread. So, we're going to put this piece of bread inside of the plastic bag and we're going to close it really well, okay? The next one, though, we're going to add a little bit of water. So, you know how to use pipettes? You can use an eyedropper or just pour the water on top. Okay, so we're going to make it nice and wet. All right, a little bit more. Because if we want things to grow on it, well, we want to make it a little bit nicer for them to grow. They love water, pretty much like anyone else. Okay, I think that's enough. So now we're going to place this inside of the bag as well. Now, on to bread slice number 3. So this one will be a dry slice of bread, but it's going to have a little bit of salt. Okay? Now, remember when I told you that a lot of times people use salt as a preservative? And that means that when there's a lot of salt, not very many things will like to grow. Okay, and what I showed you was an experiment where I made a special type of medium or jelly, well, jelly food for bacteria, and I added a lot of salt to one of it. And do you remember what happened? Not very many things grew there because there was a lot of salt. So now we're going to see if things will actually grow on the bread now that there's a lot of salt on it. Okay, if you want, you guys can also put it on the other side. Now, this one, the last one, will be wet bread with salt. Okay, so let's add a little bit of water. Doop de doop de doop de doop de doop de doop de doop. A little more. Let's try to add just about as much water as we added on the previous one. I think it was about this much. Okay, and now let's add the salt. So, we want to make sure that we have similar conditions, and only one thing will be different in each case. So, we started with really dry bread with nothing else. Then, here we have dry bread with salt. So, the difference is that now we have salt, and we're going to see if the salt will help or will stop the growth of different fungus and molds. In this case, we added some water. So we're going to see whether the water is going to help or will stop the growth of different fungus and mold. And in the last case, we're adding also some salt. So on top of the bread being wet, we're going to add a little bit of salt and see whether that's going to change anything. So what we're going to do, guys, is after we put them in the baggies, we're going to leave them for a long period of time, for a few weeks at least, and we're going to observe and watch very carefully what's going to happen. What do you guys think is going to happen? Is something going to grow on the bread? And is it going to grow on this one? On this one, or in this one, or on that one, or maybe it's gonna grow on two of them and not the other two. Which ones do you think will be the best for growing fungus and mold? Which ones do you think will be the ones that will not let anything grow on it. Would it be the wet one or the one with salt? Or maybe just the dry one or the one that's wet but also has salt? All right, I'm going to leave this experiment for you to observe and for you to record the results. I'm going to be very curious for you to tell me when something grows or when something doesn't grow. All right, happy experimenting, guys. See you soon.